The transformation that we started in Apogee 2 years ago was in anticipation of a shift that has happened not only in print, but in the entire IT and communication industry towards as a service. At Apogee, we have been trying to be very selective in starting with services that are in the IT world, closer to the capabilities that we have developed over the course of 25 years in print. I definitely want to emphasize that it's not just drag and drop of the capability. There have been investments that we have done and investments that we are doing in Apogee in upskilling our infrastructure.
Hello and welcome to In the Spotlight with Quocirca, the definitive podcast on digital disruption in the print industry. I'm Luella Fernandez, director of Quocirca, and today I'm joined by Aurelio Maruggi, CEO of Apogee. Apogee is a wholly owned subsidiary of HP, and today we'll be discussing Apogee's ambitions in the managed IT services space. So welcome to the show, Aurelio. It's great to have you here today.
Hello, Luella. I'm very glad to be here with you today.
Yeah, great to have you here. So I know you've been in the industry for quite some time. Could you maybe share with us your career history and your role at Apogee today?
Yes, indeed. It's quite an experience. This year is 36 years that I've been in the printing industry. And of course, I've been in different roles, mostly on the so-called manufacturer side of the printing industry. The last 2 years is when I've been leading Apogee, that is more on the go-to-market or on the front face to customers side of the printing industry. Always enjoyed every single year of this 36. Always enjoyed to be always on the kind of forefront of either creating new opportunity for print or transforming part of print. This is a kind of a common thread that I have throughout the 36 years of career.
Yeah, and it's interesting because I attended the sales event you had recently, and it was really inspiring to hear about the transformation that Apogee's undergone over the past few years and your goals and targets around managed IT services. So could you tell us a bit about your strategy moving from being a traditional managed print or managed workplace provider to managed IT services?
Yeah, definitely. In the technology world, of course, the evolution is happening at an accelerated pace. And for every company, transformation is not an option. It's something that has to be embraced. It has to be embraced. It's always think ahead of the curve, ahead of when things become visible, known in the market, but also becomes trends that are clear to everybody. And so the transformation that we started in Apogee is a transformation that started and is grounded on the solid foundation that Apogee has as a print service provider, but is really rooted on the second word, is the service provider. And so Apogee has been developing capabilities and skills that are around providing service to clients. And even before providing service, understanding client problem, identifying solution, and then be able to wrap the proper service around the solution and support that solution throughout the entire life cycle. So the transformation that we started in Apogee 2 years ago was in anticipation of a shift that has happened not only in print, but in the entire IT and communication industry towards as a service. As I said, is rooted on a strong foundation of being able to provide services to our client, and is also rooted on a very strong foundation in terms of the client that we serve every single day.
Yeah, and it's interesting because we've done quite a bit of research on the managed IT services opportunity for traditional MPS providers. And I'm curious because we're definitely seeing that organizations are more receptive to using a single provider for both print and IT services. And however, it does require a big change in mindset and also skills and expertise. So could you tell us a bit about how you're growing that organically in terms of changing your approach to the market and also investing in training and resources and talent in that space?
Yeah, absolutely. And first of all, let's put in context of how vast is the space, the IT space or the managed IT space, because of course we think to IT as the individual component, but when you put together all the parts of IT that include device, software, product, cloud services, it is a very large market opportunity and is also a very vast market opportunity in terms of the different segment. In terms of size of the opportunity, we estimate for the UK market only that this market has an annual spend of about £15 billion. And out of that, just to put again things in context, print represents only 10%. So there is a 90% opportunity that is addressable in IT. And then the other reference point is how much of this IT spend is already in a certain form of as a service or associated with services. And this a number that is large and is growing at about 2x the rate of growth of the IT service market, because the IT the IT market is growing at about 4.3%. The as a service part of the IT market is growing at 9%. So, and represents 60% of the total IT spend. So the opportunity is very large in the non-print IT and is even larger and faster growing into the IT service. Now, I go back from where I started. However, there are many different segments into this IT market, and the identification of these segments and the selection of these segments and the investment in developing the capability in this segment is the secret for success, or the assurance of avoiding failure. And this is what at Apogee we have been trying to be very selective in starting with services that are in the IT world, closer to the capabilities that we have developed over the course of 25 years in print. This is why we launched last year IT services that are more device related IT services, like PC peripherals, conferencing systems, whiteboards, and so on and so forth, while we expect to launch later this year other services that requires additional capability to be built, and services in segments like networking, in general communication, cloud service, security, productivity.
There are some synergies between the print space and the IT space, and those areas you mentioned, cloud, security, networks, and so on, is really the opportunity for MPS providers to build IT expertise in that space. So can you give examples of perhaps of customers that are using, types of customers that are using Apogee for both areas? Are there particular, do they tend to be the larger companies, or are you finding the smaller companies are more likely to be looking for one supplier for both?
Let me start from the second question. We see definitely a good mix of medium and large size clients, what we call strategic enterprise and public sector, and also SMEs that have not only shown interest, but they've engaged with our company, and with several of them, we have already developed solution and deployed solution in the IT space. Now, in terms of how we approach, and this is the similarity that exists to the way we have approached the development of solution for the managed print space, is really through what we call a journey. A journey that really starts from understanding the customer environment and the customer needs. So this is almost a consultative approach that that we have. We have a large, we call professional service team, that that is a team of engineers that have really a consultative approach to engage with clients. They never talk about the specific product. They never talk about the specific software solution that is delivered. Sometimes vendors, they do not like it because they would like to start from it is an HP product or is a paper cut solution. We never start from there. We start from understanding what the client needs, and then we start developing the solution that can address the needs of the client. And a lot of time, these solutions are more projected into what the clients not only need today, but what we'll need in the course of the coming years. The solution is properly architected, is properly developed, and then the even more important part, that solution is deployed to the clients and is supported throughout the life cycle. Now, what I've described to you in terms of the journey is the journey that we've been using now for many, many years in the managed print space. But if you consider, for example, identifying for a client what is the right fleet of laptop and desktop that fit what are the needs of the client, and identifying what are also the software solution that needs to be loaded on this laptop, what are the remote connectivity that this laptop need to have in order to be properly monitored and properly managed, there is a staggering analogy of what we have been doing for many years in the print world, or what we are doing with some of the client into this early deployment of IT-related solution. And again, the key is identifying what the client needs, not starting from selling a product or selling a solution, developing the solution, deploying the solution, and then have an organization that is able to support, either because there is a call center that is able every day to answer calls from clients, or there is a field service organization that can reach out to clients and resolve problem on site, or an organization that is able to procure the right level of hardware, configuring the right way, and delivering in any corner of the country. So these are the capability where there is leverage, but I definitely want to emphasize that it's not just drag and drop of the capability. There have been investments that we have done and investments that we are doing in Apogee in upskilling our infrastructure, our resources, in order to be able to offer the exact same dependable service that we're providing in the print world into the IT world.
Yeah, that's really interesting to hear, because, you know, I think, as you say, Apogee had already made the investment to move beyond the transactional approach to MPS, and you're already delivering multi-vendor services. So you have those capabilities to understand the kind of diversity of the market and offer, I guess, best of breed solutions. And I think, you know, managed IT services is very much about focusing on business outcomes. So that kind of solutions consulting approach is not focused on speeds and feeds and hardware features and benefits. So, you know, I think that's great that you can leverage that expertise already to move into that IT services space. So in terms of that strategy to move into IT services, do you have any specific goals by 2025 you discussed at your recent event, but do you see any particular challenges in getting to that goal, or what are the opportunities, or maybe how you're going to drive growth over that period?
Yeah, definitely the goal that we have first and foremost is to expand the services that we are providing to our existing client base. Apogee, as you may know, has a very large client base in excess of 11,000 clients that every day, as I said, they are depending on our print service solution. We are definitely starting from this client base and extending to them as we develop and deploy these capabilities into IT services with an approach that is the one that I described before, that is a roadmap of capabilities that will come to life. This will allow us to grow the share of wallet with our clients. In terms of the goals that we have, is they are indeed for the managed IT services to become a material part of our business by 2025, and material means represent from one quarter to one third of the business, and of course the first year is is this one, and we have already ambitious goal in terms of the penetration that we will have with our customers, and I'm very pleased to report that at least the start of the year was very encouraging of getting there. So as I said, will be a journey, will not be a material contributor to Apogee's financials in this fiscal year, but definitely it is expected to be a material contributor to our business and even more to our growth in the next 3 years.
So I mentioned at the beginning that you're actually wholly owned by HP. Can you talk a bit about the relationship with HP and how that drives your strategy or how it supports your strategy, not just for IT services, but for other elements of the business?
Yeah, the short answer is that nothing has changed since the onset following the acquisition that HP did of Apogee. Apogee is a fully owned subsidiary of HP, so it is 100% of the ownership of Apogee is with HP. However, and this is, as I said, very consistent with what was declared by HP at the time of acquisition, it is an independently run subsidiary of HP. There is really no integration of Apogee into HP in terms of systems, in terms of commercial relationship. Apogee is and will continue to be treated by HP as one of the many valuable partners that HP has in UK and in other parts of the world. But of course, there are opportunities where we see some leverage that we can create between Apogee and HP, and where we can maximize the shareholder value that we can create, or the technology share that we can have in the UK market. A perfect example is what we have done in public sector in UK. In the UK, the public sector has been moderately addressed by HP until recently, when in certain public sector frameworks, Apogee and HP have joined forces, providing, there is a joint approach into the framework and bringing at disposal of HP all the capabilities that Apogee has in terms of capability in professional services, as I was describing before, capability in terms of service and so on and so forth. So there are certain areas where still maintaining the clear model of independency between HP and Apogee, we find opportunities for some leverage in order to maximize overall the participation of HP technology and HP brand in the marketplace.
Yeah, and you mentioned that, I think mostly we've spoken about the UK market, but could you talk a bit about Apogee's footprint in other European regions and how is that on your strategy as well to expand your presence in other regions as well?
Yeah, also here is something that was declared at the time of the acquisition, that the intention was to grow the footprint of Apogee outside the UK. We are currently present in Ireland and Germany, and we are actively exploring further expansion in the rest of Europe. Fortunately, I cannot be more specific of where and what are these plans, but definitely those plans that we have declared are still very much active, and we are working in two directions. On one side is growing where we are already present in Ireland and Germany, and also identifying the best approach in order to open other operations in other countries in Europe.
So just coming back to the IT services space, just to finish on really, is it sounds really positive in terms of your planned journey towards your goals, and also the fact you can leverage the expertise in your existing professional services group. But do you think there will also be plans for any acquisitions in the managed IT services space to reach certain markets and just immediately be able to be effective in certain sectors with IT services?
Yeah, I've been always in my professional life a strong believer that the growth of a company has to be looked at both with organic investment and with inorganic investment and with acquisition, and Apogee will not be any different. And especially as we will look at opportunity for acquisition, there are two categories of acquisition that we'll be looking at. Acquisition of companies that will increase further the scale that we have in terms of client base. And in this category falls the acquisition that we did in March of last year with Direct Tech, that is an MPS provider that has been fully integrated in Apogee. And the second category are acquisition for bringing in expertise, capabilities, and knowledge that will accelerate our path to enter into segment of IT.
Yeah, and I know we haven't talked much about the kind of MPS. I mean, you just mentioned the acquisition there in that space. But in terms of your views on the market for printing, you know, I don't think it's going to disappear completely. But, you know, obviously that's still core to your business. What are your views on how MPS is going to continue to transform perhaps over the next 2 to 3 years?
Market-wise, I definitely expect, as we have already experienced in the past several years, consolidation. Definitely there is consolidation that is happening and will continue to happen at an accelerated pace. This is primarily because this market, I mentioned before, in the SMB, the total print market in UK is 10% of the total spend, so it's approximately £1.5 billion. The CAGR, the compound annual growth rate, is negative. So there is no disillusion on the fact that the print market has not the perspective to grow, but is not a negative in terms of being double-digit negative. Is single-digit negative. We have seen an acceleration of that decline driven by the COVID pandemic. There has been some specific decline due to the office that have been vacated during the COVID, but the return to the office has definitely showed that some of the print that was happening pre-COVID has disappeared and has disappeared forever. Mm-hmm. So in that respect, our projection have been done based on a decline in terms of overall footprint in devices that are with client and volume of print that is material for the business. So we are talking about, in terms of volume of pages, we are projecting a decline that is in the range of 15-20% at least, yeah, from pre-COVID to post-COVID. And then from there will continue the steady, slow decline of volume of print. So by no means doom and gloom, but definitely if you are sit on a company like Apogee and you want, as we want, to continue to drive growth, it was absolutely an imperative 2 years ago for us to start this investment journey, this transformation that will allow us to continue to count on a very solid basis of managed print service business that will be, let me say, slightly declining, and the growth represented by managed IT services. Now, where we are in our managed print service business, decelerating the decline that is happening like for like, is through two areas. One is growing market share in MPS, and the primary area where we have a tremendous opportunity for growing market share is in public sector. We have done a lot of investment and will continue to do a lot of investment. I mentioned also some of the partnership that we have with HP, but it's not only through HP, but it's also through the participation that Apogee has in virtually every single framework that exists in UK, growing market share in public sector. The second is through eventually some selective acquisition of client base. So it's growing market share with the combination of winning new business, both in private and public sector, but every public sector represents the biggest opportunity, and through inorganic growth.
Yeah, and I think that's the kind of strategy that, you know, we see happening a lot in the industry, because, like you say, it's very unlikely that print volumes will ever bounce back to pre-COVID levels. You know, I think the pandemic has really brought about a permanent change in behavior from us as individuals and businesses, and there's been a big shift to digitization of, you know, documents and people getting used to working without printing. So I think, you know, that's having an impact, as you say, on the whole industry, and it makes sense to gain more market share from a declining market while innovating in new business areas. So it sounds, you know, that's absolutely what Apogee is doing, I guess, with its move into IT services. So it's been really great to hear about Apogee's strategy. You know, it's interesting also that the public sector, but also IT services space. So, you know, I'll definitely be following closely to hear more from Apogee in the future. So I just wanted to finish on a final question, which we're asking to all the guests, which is just a lighthearted question. So what was your first job, maybe before you entered the print industry? And what lessons did you learn or advice can you get from that?
Oh, yes, that's a very interesting question. First of all, my first job was in the printing industry. I really started right after college in the printing industry. What was something that really struck me and has been with me for the rest of my career is actually there are two things. One, that coming out of 5 years of university and with my master in electronic engineering, I thought that I didn't know everything, but close to everything when it comes to electronic engineering. And then I went into a company that was developing printer, and I was sent in the mix of developing electronic. And so going from the theory in working into an environment to develop commercial product was quite a leap, and I had to learn a lot. So I learned that as much as you think you have learned, there is more that you need to learn in whatever you are doing. This was the first learning. Second learning is that I didn't realize throughout the college that I had picked the technology sector, that I picked it as technology sector, a sector that is evolving at a amazing or crazy pace. So I realized that a lot of what I had studied that was just fresh of 1 year or 2 years was either already obsolete or was very, very quickly becoming obsolete. And this, the second learning is that wherever you are in your position, either in terms of your professional position or as a company, standing still leads you to fall behind very, very, very quickly. And so these are the two learning that I had from the first few months in the job.
That's great advice, actually, because I think in the technology industry, you can't afford to rest on your laurels or stand still, because you will become irrelevant. And I think that's a real challenge for the print industry and its channel partners. And, you know, Apogee is definitely looking at areas of growth, and, you know, the fact that you've always been involved in transformational positions, I think really bodes well for Apogee. So thanks again for your time, Aurelio. It's been really interesting to hear about Apogee's strategy, and I look forward to speaking to you again in the future.
Thank you, Luella, for the opportunity, and thanks for the viewers that will watch this podcast.
So thank you for joining today's episode of In the Spotlight with Quocirca. For more information, please visit quocirca.com and be sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel. Thanks again for watching, and I look forward to seeing you in our next episode.